All right, so disclaimer, I have a leftover migraine and I am, not feeling well. But I want to get these turkey burgers in. So some of y'all are barbecuing today and you might have some folks who want turkey burgers and they are infamously dry. So what I did yesterday was really massage the turkey meat. You can judge my pan. That's the bacon drippings from yesterday. It's about to be amazing. So I massaged the turkey meat with a spice blend. I'll put a picture of the spice blend up, but Cajun seasoning in there, jerk, smoked sea salt, some really nice flavorful things. Let it sit overnight in that. Got a couple green peppers and a few of the patties for people who like that. What I'm gonna do is I got some sauce here, which is some barbecue, a little bit of pineapple juice, some hot sauce, you know, kind of a sweet situation to go with the really savory, savory, flavorful dry seasonings I put on. So I'm gonna hit the patties with a little bit of this. I'm gonna put them in the oven and get them brown before I put them on the grill. Now, notice the outside situation. I'm not going out there. I'll be grilling inside on a George Foreman grill. Shout out to Labor Day. I'm also gonna try to add in a little bit of savory moisture from some cheese. So the Parmesan cheese has come up, rosemary and garlic, Parmesan cheese. I'm gonna hit it with a little bit of this. And so we will see what happens if our turkey burgers are moist or if they are dry like sawdust. So anyway, brown sugar cooks occasionally, even with a migraine. I'll let y'all know how they come out. Oh, and then the bacon drippings, gonna add some extra moisture and flavor as well. I'm about to flip them over so that they can be evenly situated with that. All right, peace. All right, so the patties have been sauced and sprinkle a little bit of the cheese on it. When I flip them over, I will sauce the other side and put a little cheese on them. And I'm gonna leave these in the oven until that sauce is kind of soaked in to the patties and the cheese is gone, disappeared. All right,
so just flip them over. Let you see one on the other side, but they smell amazing already. By the time they hit the grill, they'll just be getting, you know, grill marks and all that, but you can already see how moist that is. We need that smell-o-vision situation because these smell ridiculous. So I'm gonna put a little more of the sauce on there. Sauce is running low, but should be enough to just dot them. Dot them with a little bit of sauce. So like when I say moist, like these are about to be crazy. So, or about to be amazing. So I got a little bit of sauce on them. Then I'm gonna hit them with a little more of the rosemary. What is it now? Kraft, I see you. Rosemary and garlic, Parmesan cheese. And again, that's just gonna add some savoriness. I may still put a slice of cheese on them when we're serving them, but you know, they'll be there. So you can make a batch without those if you have some non-dairy people in your cookout life. So I'll put them back in for about 3 minutes and then hit the grill. So that's the end. Here go the condiments I'm gonna put on. Nice white American brown sugar bacon that I made yesterday from scratch in the oven. Well, I mean, I didn't make the bacon, but you know, I made the bacon. All right, I got no burger rolls right now, so we're gonna work with that bread. And then here are your finished burgers. Super moist. I mean, these two right here, I didn't even put any drizzle on. Like, you can just see the shine. They've got some nice fat in there. All that juice is sealed in because they went into the oven before they hit the grill situation. And yes, I am grilling in sight of outdoors on the George Foreman grill. Y'all would do. Alright, so those are brown sugar, bacon, moist turkey burgers. So if anybody tries to serve you dry turkey burgers today, Labor Day, tell them that ain't right. Hit the YouTube. Bit of brown sugar. Peace.